Hi, this is Ceramic85. I did a lot of videos on this channel helping thousands of people to fix their cars and trucks. Now I need your help, please. My truck has a problem and so far I and no one else seems to be able to fix it. Here's what happened. I was driving down the road at around 25 miles per hour. It was a very foggy day at around 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Engine was warmed up and no check engine light was on. Engine was just running fine. Suddenly, while driving, engine shuts off, dashboard and lights out, in the middle of the road. I tried to turn it back on, but nothing. Just quiet. I had the AAA look at it since I didn't have a clue what it could be, and the guy said that it should be an electrical problem since there obviously was no spark. Since I couldn't figure out why, I had to get the truck towed home. First thing I noticed was the fuel pump fuse was blown, so I replaced that. Then when I turned the key, the dash came on and the check engine light came on. I hooked up my laptop and read out the code. It was P1391. This is the freeze frame data that was stored. Since P1391 stands for a faulty signal of the camshaft position sensor or crankshaft position sensor, I replaced both of them. To make sure, I also replaced the ignition coil, the distributor cap, the rotor, as well as the spark plugs and wires. After this, I was able to start the car and I was so happy because I thought I fixed the problem. But as soon as the engine reaches operating temperature, it starts to run really rough at around 1600 RPM. By the way, the clicking noise are just the injectors. And if I take the foot off the gas, it runs fine at idle. If I try to get over 1700 RPM, it sounds like it's having misfires caused by missing fuel or missing sparks. The more I step on the gas, the worse the engine runs until it shuts off. It shut off on a lot of time. By the way, if the engine is cold, it is no problem to go over 1700 RPM. I decided to change out the ECU engine computer. So I got a used one off of eBay and replaced it, but it didn't have any effect on the problem and everything stayed the same. I had this truck in two garages because of this issue. They said they checked all the wires and sensors again and that they were okay. When they went into the cylinders with their camera, they found a tiny crack in the cylinder head on cylinder number 1, as you can see here. They said that this could be the problem and they offered to take apart the whole engine. But since them looking at it already cost me tons of money and I didn't want them to take apart the whole car, I towed the truck back home and looked at it myself again. Now I'm asking you for help. If you might know what the problem could be, please let me know. I tried to explain the problem as accurate as possible here, but if you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer you down in the comments. Of course, I will make a detailed video about the solution of this problem once we're there, to help others in case they have the same issue. But until then, please help me, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and thank you for your support to make this channel better. This is Ceramic85 signing out.